A lot of women when they say they were raped anyways.
It's shocking.
This is the true story.
Whatever. Of seven strangers.
Picked to live in a house.
Volunteer some time.
I need help.
And have the lives taped.
To find out what happens
when people stop being polite.
Montana.
Start getting real.
The real world.
Boston.
Social butterfly, I'm gonna meet people no matter what. If I got both my feet chopped off and had one arm, I'm still gonna meet people.
There was a mother that has a crush on Syrus at the community center. I saw her last night.
Oh, God, she's so cute.
I know.
I liked her when I first saw her.
I did.
Kind of pissed me off that she wanted to date you instead of me.
Good enough.
She's really cute.
Then my son screamed at the top of his lungs that his mom was interested in me.
The boy's mom just kind of went up to Syrus and started talking to him.
Hey.
Half the parents there are single parents, I bet. They're looking for a guy. And it's simple supply and demand. The supply is there at the after-school program. Bunch of single parents, gang of mothers coming through the door. And whoever's in demand better step up to the plate. You pitch a curve, it's over the fence.
Alright,
no, that's cool.
Say the magical word.
Hi.
Should have honked it when it came out. You have any clue where we're going?
No.
Me neither.
I cannot believe that one of the mothers from the center was in our house and was going out with Syrus.
That's unprofessional to me. It's sick. And don't let Anthony find out. Oh my gosh. I don't care what Syrus does. I'm not his mother. But when it concerns all of us, like that mess right there, that's when I have a problem. I don't care if Syrus sees 20 single mothers at one time, as long as they don't go to the center, as long as we don't see those kids, and as long as those kids don't see Syrus with their mother.
Father let you date? Does he mind? Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't he kind of... Does he have some skill?
Mm-mm.
No?
That was awesome.
My first girlfriend was Terry. Back in sixth grade. Her grandfather went nuts on me. On the phone. Called me every name in the book. He knew just from my name.
Well, I kind of just got used to it because I've never...
Dude,
my own
race. Oh, are you that close-minded?
No.
I wonder what's gonna happen if Syrus keeps dating that girl. You know what I mean? Like, if he's
I
really
don't
truly
think about it.
I just thought that it was very unprofessional. You know, I knew that she was one of the children's mothers, and I just thought that she had no place being there with Syrus.
What if he disses her, or what if she gets pissed off, or what if she falls in love? Like, all these what-ifs.
I mean, is that even allowed? Do you think?
What?
I mean, do you think Anthony would allow that to happen?
There are just some women in our, some men and women right now that are just off limits to us.
Have you met all the women? No, you haven't met them, huh?
Not all of them, no.
I can't believe they didn't say hi right there. How was going to introduce you? Because that's how rude that one girl is. She,
really?
You know, I didn't
say anything.
I don't introduce people to them no more because I've gotten a couple bad responses, so.
I wonder what he says about us.
He's probably indifferent to most of us. I don't think he cares.
But I just think some things are so fundamental. You don't date people where you work.
That's cool. We're gonna have to play teams. You're gonna have to be on my team so you can carry our team. Ah!
We've got money.
Well, I'll give you a call.
Okay.
I'll rate you.
All right.
Drive safe. You know how to get out of here, right?
I know.
Okay, cool. See ya. You know who that was?
It's the mother of one of the kids.
I'm sure they were talking crap, huh?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
What did they say?
I didn't get it to come.
Come on.
But obviously, there's going to be some crap being talked about that.
That's hot.
Dude, you're shady.
Just trying to hook me up with a job. What are you talking about? First of all, I was the one pursued. Second of all, she's 25.
You're right. Third of all, she has a kid.
That's hot. She turned out to be a really cool person. She's my age. She's from Boston. She knows Boston. Why can't she show me around town? I got a problem right here, yo.
I know.
Early age, I experienced things through basketball that I probably wouldn't have got a chance to experience. My life is structured around basketball. Basketball will show you, you know, that no matter how good you are as an individual, you need the rest of your team. You need to work together with people in order to get things done.
Taking this seriously, and it's making me mad.
Yeah, I'll be here for sure.
Okay.
All right.
All right. You know, he was out last night all night, and now he's saying, oh, my ankle hurts, I can't go. What? You better go. Cyrus and Jason, neither of them are going, and you guys better take this seriously, and, like, if you can't go, all right, then get up and get ready.
Oh, my God.
Cyrus, what's your ankle up? Is it up? Do you want an ice bath?
That would be nice. Let's see it.
It looks like...
Ooh, dude, that looks like...
He's telling me, bro. Look at that, man.
It looks like...
The Nutty Professor. You know what
Cyrus, if your ankle's bothering you, dude, you should just go and sit there. You don't have to, like, play basketball. Just go
the
and play
kid
with the
wasn't
kids.
Kick me in my ankle, girl. Do you know? I'm telling you, straight
up. I think that's a weak excuse. I think you don't want to go just because you don't want to go, not because your ankle. You can go out all last night with your ankle hurting.
If I don't want to go, I don't give a damn. You want my mommy.
No, I'm not. I'm just sitting. No.
I'm going to be talking to... I don't want to hear that. I'm an adult. I make my own damn decisions. If I don't want to go, I won't go. If
right,
I feel good enough to go, I would have went.
We do get judged as a group in this thing. And if you don't go because you've been out late and you don't feel like going, that looks bad for all of us, not just
late.
For you.
I ain't got nothing to do with that, baby.
What does that have to do with that?
Look at my ankle. That's what it has to do with. Look at my ankle. It wasn't this big before I left yesterday, and it ain't this big now. Yeah, I could walk up in there if I wanted to, but it ain't gonna get no better. As far as walking 2-3 blocks, forget that. As far as getting off that seat and having to kick the bus down to the place, I can really forget that. Personally, I don't give a damn.
I want to know, what is everybody's opinion, because I don't really have one, on Syrus having that woman come over to the house from the after-school center?
I think it's a bad idea. I think it's just, I think that there could be problems. I don't think he should use the after-school program as another way to pick up women.
What happens if Syrus and this woman, like, get in a fight or something, you know?
What happens if they get attached, if he starts to feel like, you know?
Where does this little boy stand in all this? And that gives us a bad name.
Well, I was thinking of asking Anthony what his policy on the whole thing was.
I don't want to sit there and say who I feel unless I'm going to sit down and talk to Syrus first, you know?
Even Syrus is saying, I know people are saying about this whole deal.
They are, and they should go to his face and tell him what they think.
Right, but that's why I was told. I'm curious.
But you know what, though? They won't.
Don't say that we're wrong for talking about him behind his back, because you're going to come asking us what we think about the situation, because it's the same thing.
I'm not saying you're talking about his back.
Everybody gets talked about behind their
exactly.
back.
Like Syrus doesn't have his opinion about each and every one of us. Does he say it to us to our face?
No. I went in his room this morning and told him how I felt, and that'll be the last time that I'll do it.
So you felt like you didn't have a bad place to say that to him?
You don't feel that way? That his behavior is a reflection of all
you guys? No, you guys don't reflect on me, I don't think. I can only do what I'm going to do.
These bagels are all moldy.
Is Anthony still here? Did he just walk out?
I think Anthony's here.
Why don't you talk to me in private about that? Okay? Reflex.
I'm not going to tell him. I'm not going to be any mediator or go-between or anything like that.
I'm not
going to stick my nose in people's business.
But it's already become a big issue.
One of the parents was at our house this past weekend.
Really?
It's against agency policy.
Then you better have a talk with Cyrus. Okay, well, come tell me what you said.
I just asked Anthony if they had any policy on people dating the parents in the center, and he said yes, they definitely did, and it's strictly prohibited. And I said, then you better have a talk with Syrus.
She told him it was Syrus?
Yeah, she did.
She told him it was Syrus.
Girl, I know that! That's why I'm laughing.
She said it is so-and-so.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure.
I was talking to Elka. We were sitting there eating, and Elka tells me that Montana didn't tell that it was Syrus who asked who went out with the mother.
I asked Montana if she mentioned Syrus' name. She said no. I guess there's nothing like being lied to by your own roommate.
I don't know. I don't think that Montana had the right to go in and even discuss this with Anthony. I thought that Montana could have dealt with that situation in a much more positive way.
So how much did you get for those two teeth?
$10.
You got $10? No, you didn't. No, you did not. You got $10? Do you know how much I got for my teeth? I got 25 cents for each tooth.
She hates that man.
Like, I don't like him, but he does his thing. I don't care. He lives in the house. So what? She wants him out of there. We want her out of there. See, I don't want anyone to leave. It's confirmed she is a troublemaker, but still, I mean, that's one aspect of her personality. The other is she's really good with kids, and that's what we're here to do.
Hello?
No, he's not.
Cyrus isn't here right now. Can I take a message?
Okay, let me give you the names, because it could be a lot of people. Can you tell me? Can you tell me?
Rhonda, Aaron.
Uh-huh.
Heather. Hold on a second. You're going a little bit too fast. Heather, okay. Heather.
Amanda.
Aaron.
And Gab and Rhonda.
What was the one before Rhonda? I can't hear you.
Just hang up.
Okay, I'm going to hang up now, though. Make sure and tell me you called. Bye.
Montana and Sire are definitely going to have a hard time. We've been together for the entire time. You know, and I don't really like see anybody coming to any sort of epiphanies about one another. I don't see anybody going, oh, I forgive you for who you are. That crap ain't going to happen, man. They are two separate entities in their own worlds.
Everyone in this house.
Everyone in this house, but yeah, it's not so difficult to get along with some people. You know, it's really not. It's like, I have my opinions on things. I know the way I am. But I can also respect other people's. I can respect where they're coming from. I can. And I think other people in this house can too.
Montana went and had a conversation with him.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard two stories. One was that she only asked what the policy was for us dating others. And I also heard another story that said she told me you were dating
her. Oh my goodness.
This old girl's a ringleader, huh? Damn, I can't wait till I can get on something.
Don't get fired from this thing, because I'm busting your ass.
That'd be a bunch of drama.
Yep, we don't need it.
There's a possibility that if Syrus keeps dating this woman, that he'll be fired from the after-school program for kids.
I'm sorry if I put you on the spot, man. What up?
Well, that's all right. I didn't think that she had a right to ask Anthony about your situation.
I don't think she has a right to do. I'm good with her, man. If I get a chance to take her down, she's going down, dude. Any little thing I can do.
I still don't know some of the kids' names.
Uh-huh.
I have nothing in common with these people.
Mm-hmm.
I have no experience with kids. I don't have a kid of my own. What do I say to these kids? Hi, how you doing? I don't know your name.
Hey, you gotta calm down, little man. Hold up. Listen, if you're not comfortable, what do we do?
You can do it, Genesis. It's really not that hard.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously.
I don't want to.
Ay, ay, ay. Okay.
That's cool. You don't have to do anything you don't want to do.
Thank you. Cyrus is getting really close to getting fired.
No way.
I think he is.
Nah, because Anthony's been totally cool about this whole deal.
The fact that he had the nerve to date a mother there, regardless of who liked who, where the hell is his head?
Bottom line is, he's not bringing anything to the program.
If I was his boss, I wouldn't have an employee like that. Shows up late, puts his feet up on the chair. Anthony's watching.
Whoa.
Don't doubt it. Sean, when I asked you before, when I said, do you think Cyrus should be allowed to stay in the house if he should happen to get fired from the community center, you said, no, I don't think that he should be able to stay in the house.
No, I didn't. I would never kick him out for that.
Cyrus?
You wouldn't kick him out for getting fired from the center. No. You'd let him just, like, live there and sleep late and party all night because we have to be at work the next day.
No,
and stuff like
real
that.
People come
if Cyrus,
Cyrus gets fired, he needs to leave the house.
Mm-hmm.
We are here to work for the community service center.
Why not?
That's the deal.
Yeah,
there's no way that he's gonna come in, live rent-free, but not work, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
You guys feel that strong that
I'll
he's on the verge of getting kicked out of the after-school program for kids, and if he does, that you're gonna kick him out of the house?
I think he needs to go. I mean, because there's so many people who want to be in Cyrus's position right now and who are willing
to work.
Who
could add something to that center? We could get somebody in that house and make it a really cool place to be.
Hey, what's up, big man?
Hey.
Okay.